Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Kinguin Pro League 2015. This is going to be the fourth match of the day. We're about to cast the very end of the day. We have five today, so we have two more, but both will involve Firebat. So we're going to see two Firebat matches and also a second match from Strifecrow. The first one is going to be Savic versus Firebat into Strifecrow Firebat, so very high-level matches, and I'm really excited to see what those players brought, since they tend to be very solid players. Is Firebat here? That's a good question, actually. Yeah. I don't hear you.
My mic didn't work. I don't know why. I clicked it like 20 times, you know?
Yeah, it's fine. Mine does the same thing. I have to just mash on it 20 times until the little light glows red.
Blue, why you do this?
Yeah, why you do that? Why you do that? Why do that? All right, so we have Savic versus Firebat. The first match is going to be, pitting them against one another. Savic has Druid, Mage, Warrior, and Firebat brought Mage, Priest, and Warrior, so they have one class difference. Firebat is bringing Priest, where Savic is bringing Druid, so apparently both players think Mage and Warrior are either good classes to exploit their opponent, or they think they're just overall the best metagame classes.
I think Firebat brought the Warrior to exploit Savic, because he's known for playing
Freeze Mage.
Yeah, Freeze Mage. Yeah.
I think that's a really good call on his part, honestly.
Look, first game.
You can first game, Mage versus Warrior, yeah. It's going to be Savic versus... I guess for Savic, it's Mage versus Firebat's Warrior, right?
Yeah, I would really love Savic to play mind games here and bring a mech mage. Like a really solid one against Warrior.
Or even so just a value mage. You play value mage with Belchers and duplicate, and you win. Like, the Warrior is running out of removal very, very fast in that matchup. So I think that would be a really nice thing. If Savic did that, then that would be crazy. Otherwise, Firebat, like, we've known Firebat for trying to exploit his opponent's lineups. So yeah. He may be trying to do the same here to Savic, but we'll have to see if Savic reacted in the same way.
If he would actually pay attention to the last series of Firebat, he would have seen the pattern, right, of countering his opponents.
Yeah, always trying to get the perfect read on their lineups and bring the exact opposite.
Well,
so
look at
Savic
that.
Has a Kazan Mystic and his possible Freeze Mage, I'm guessing.
I'm not sure if that's a Freeze Mage.
Well, I saw a Frost Nova in the starting hand that got mulliganed away. Well, there it is. So you said, and I quote, "This isn't as bad a matchup as it used to be for Freeze Mage because Archmage Antonidas."
Because of Emperor and Antonidas.
And Antonidas, yes, exactly.
With but the you have to get those two, those exact two cards at the right moment.
Okay, if you get so that. It's still a terrible matchup, though.
Yeah, it's still terrible. So we are into a Resonant Sleeper here.
Well, I mean, it's we're supposed to cast this, Lothar. We can't really fall asleep.
No.
Although I'm half tempted to do exactly that. The problem is, like, you see Savic's Kazan Mystic, it's a completely dead card in this matchup.
No, it's a 4-3, what are you talking about?
Yeah, you're right. Never mind. It doesn't die to the Deathbite and Fiery War Axe and Sludge Belcher.
Yeah, completely fine card.
Yeah, completely it's great. This fine matchup. Card. What could it be great against, though? Okay, I have an idea. Firebat plays Sneed's Old Shredder, and out come Trades Prince Gallywix. Which gives Firebat a secret from Savic, and then he steals it back.
No way! Really?
Yeah. That's a great play.
Awesome.
That's what I would do. I would play around that. I mean, Sneeds is great. Firebat seems very excited to play this match.
Isn't
you know
that
what?
The picture?
Firebat
oh, no,
last
it is.
Week. yeah, last week Firebat actually played up. He queued his warrior into a freeze mage, and he just conceded. He just escape conceded right away, first 5 seconds of the match. He saw what it was and he just left.
Maybe he wanted Savic to do the same.
Yeah, maybe he thought the same would happen, but he's going to have to fight it out. Now he's debating shield slamming, but I mean, how many targets are you really going to have against Freeze Mage? Might as well take it.
And you have double armor smith. The armor will stack so fast. Firebot would not be able to count it.
You know, that's a great bot name. I'm gonna make a bot called Firebot. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make like a Hearthstone bot called Firebot, and it's gonna get you to Legend and BlizzCon every single year without fault. Alright, so
Well, he got the Antonidas, but he doesn't have Ice Lances and Emperor. So this kind of sucks.
Well, he's got a Frostbolt, does that count?
Not yet. Okay. He has to use it on the Armorsmith. Because that's the one of the cards that basically says, okay, you lose the game for sure.
It's funny how OTK Mage is actually more consistent than Freeze Mage against Control Warrior. You can actually get the Sorcerer Apprentices with Echo of Medivh, and it's much easier to pull off the infinite damage fireball combo.
Say that to Savir.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's not a deck that I'd bring to any tournament because it's so hard to beat, but if I were given, like, a deck to bring, knowing that my opponents, you know, would be bringing a Freeze Mage, I mean, Control Warrior, I might bring that version of Mage instead. Well, it's maybe a slow turn, it might be a fast one. Depends on how Firebat wants to play. He could keep the coin for Alexstrasza if he felt like it.
I think Belcher is fine.
Yeah. I mean, it doesn't even play the Flame Strike that much.
Yeah.
Alright, so Savic has Blizzard.
Interesting that he used the Belcher to kill the Thanos.
I agree. I thought the opposite was more likely. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, to kill it with Taskmaster, right?
Mm-hmm.
Second Ice Lance. He still needs the Emperor, I think.
So you can tell here that he is playing into the Sneeze, into Gallywix, into Secret Copy here, because he's keeping that Kazan Mystic. I mean, it's a very advanced play, but one you have to make nonetheless at these levels of play. I mean, you are playing against Firebat.
Wait, we didn't count how many players have Hunter.
I gave up. All of them? No, not even that close, actually. Maybe like
Savish,
five.
Savish on fire, but that...
Didn't. So Reynard
didn't
had it.
Didn't bring Hunter.
Sixo had it. Strivecrow had it. I forget. I didn't keep track.
Well, we'll count at the end of the whole broadcast then.
Don't you just Alex here instead of Grom? Okay, I guess not.
Kill it! Kill it with
the weapon. I really thought he was going to go for the Alex first. To set
Vaporize.
Up,
nope. Sorry for interrupting you.
That's no problem. And you can scream at the top of your lungs. This is supposed to be a resident sleeper. The more exciting you make it, the better off we'll be. You're going well, my Frost Nova.
Nice, but this will also be met by a Shield Slam.
Yeah, which I think is going to lead to Savich just leaving the game.
Yeah, I would say so. How do you?
I would concede in Savich's position right here. Just concede straight up. Yeah. That is your only win condition. You have nothing else. If he extends this over a few more turns. And there we go. All right. Yeah. I, no surprise there at all.
Yep.
Both players knew this was the
likely
outcome.
Faster than Hunter.
Don't lie. Don't even try.
Oh,
I'm not going to fall for it.
Wait.
What?
When they... there's no timestamp on the game on information.
They got to 10 mana. That's better than Hunter is all I can say.
The first four turns were played by, you know, ending the turn instantly.
Yeah, right. Well... That's gonna be game one for Firebat, who's got Priest and Warrior on the Priest and Mage on the back end. So Savich might stick to a Freeze Mage. It tends to do okay against, you know, Mech Mage if Firebat brought that, or against another against a Priest. It's also not too bad if they're not running Healbots and Holy Fires. You could wipe their board fairly consistently, and then finish them off with the usual 1-2 punch that you do against every other control deck.
What about? If Firebat brings also the Freeze Mage.
Whoever plays Emperor?
Yeah.
I mean, it's all about getting the combo cards first, basically.
I would say so, yeah.
So Savich is going to be sticking to his Mage, and Firebat will be moving on to Priest. So we'll have to see whether or not Firebat can get that one. I think this is generally a matchup I'd give to the Mage, but it's not 100% guaranteed. Nothing is 100% guaranteed.
In Hearthstone? No way, dude. It's all skill.
Yeah, 100% skill.
No RNG, no Athene.
No, Athene is wrong.
Can you make the impersonation again?
No, I've lost it. His spirit path through me earlier, and I got like Athene's mojo for a little while, but now it's gone. I can't get it back. Maybe if I watch more of his videos, I'll get, you know.
You have to
infuse like the Athene mentality.
You can cast the whole new
tournament
whole,
like that,
whole broadcast of the league like that, I would be dying from laughter, you know.
You'd be tired of me by like 5 minutes after the start. All right, so the game is currently on the way. We have a little bit of a spectator mode glitch, but
oh no, what, really? Oh, okay.
All right,
we'll be back with that second hand as soon as possible.
Yeah.
There's Ragnaros, which is a win card against Freeze Mage. No one is running Polymorph nowadays. So basically, when you play the Ragnaros, you win the game. Unless your opponent spends
a lot of spells to kill it. But
like
it's not
Firebolt, Frostbolt, or Pyroblasted. But that doesn't change much. Anyway.
Firebat has to use Silence here, right? Does he want to? Because then it makes his Wild Pyro go down to 1.
He can heal it, bro.
Yeah, but then he doesn't play Deathlord.
Does he have it? Does he have to play it right
Probably
now?
Probably not. No, he doesn't. I like Deathlord against Mage because you can actually force Alexstrasza out. And if you do, then you actually just win as a priest. Most of the time, at least. Because that's basically the way they win is they put you at 15 and they kill you in one turn. If Alexstrasza is forced out of the deck here by Firebat, that could be a huge deal. Wow.
Deathlord might be such a problem.
Yeah, this would be a really big deal. I mean, Firebat doesn't have Shadow Ward Death, but that still doesn't remove the fact that Alexstrasza is a cornerstone of his strategy. Now, Mad Scientist will stop deck. That's one less card that could come out of the Deathlord. Uh-oh.
This will be an RNG fest now with Deathlord. If there will be a Alexstrasza, it basically wins him the game most of the time, right?
Oh, another minion was found off the top, reducing the odds of that Deathlord spawning a non-Alexstrasza minion.
Yeah.
This is not good.
Loot Hoarder, right?
There's a Loot Hoarder at the very least one. Archmage Antonidas.
Second Doomsayer. Well, if he will get an Antonidas for free...
Well, it would have to have spells to use it. Like, he'd have to kill the Deathlord and have mana left over. But if he does, that's a crazy momentum.
Well, he can use the Fireball, right? If he gets Antonidas, look at this. He kills the Mad Scientist, he uses the Fireball, gets the Antonidas, coins out...
Mad Scientist? That's it. I mean, he's got for the time being, he's got a really weak Antonidas from Deathlord.
Yeah,
but later on,
right,
that could pay off really heavily. Alright, Firebat's got Dr. Balance in his priest deck. That guy makes his way into everything. Not Collide of Pain. A little worried about
Overdraw.
Oh, he's
going for it. No.
No, I don't think you go for it now, but... That removes one of the damage sources. Do you play Lothar for tempo? I guess you do. It locks the board, you get to deal a guaranteed... Near guaranteed 5 damage.
You push for damage with Deathlord. This is amazing. Did you see the game between Ignite and Kozkaka in Seed Story Cup?
Yes, I did. And I was crying. I was crying for him. Oh, wow. Okay, so Alex is not going to come out of that Deathlord. This has to be a relief. And in fact, you know what? This may be the best possible outcome because now Archmage is that much more likely to come out of it.
There's still one Doomsayer and one Loot Hoarder.
Wait, could Firebat mill his opponent? No, he can't. I was gonna say, could he mill him by forcing the Acolyte to draw 2 cards instead of 1?
Well, but... he can heal it up.
Oh man, there's an Emperor. Oh.
He could have, you know, he could have milled him.
By healing it up and attacked it, yeah. I thought that's what he would do initially, but he opted not to. Oh man. Savage doesn't think twice about that, but is he dead? Yeah, I was gonna say, like, this is a bit tricky, because if you drop Emperor, you have to find a way to get an Ice Block out, and so far it hasn't been done.
Wow.
You could Frostbolt Dr. Balance, I guess. Or the
no
Zombie
Frost Channel. Nova, no Blizzard. Wow.
Yeah, not very fortunate for Savage. Maybe you... Arcane Intellect. You know, you coin Arcane Intellect, find a Nova, and then drop Mad Scientist. Or find Doomslayer even off the Arcane end, but that's unlikely.
This is so bad. Thinking about the outs, but...
You could play your first Ice Block and your Mad Scientist, but that puts you in a bit of a weird spot, no matter what you do.
And there's still the Ragnaros you have to deal with.
Yeah, he doesn't know that yet, but it's a priest, so you have to expect the card is there somehow. Right, he's fetching for that Nova, 100% sure.
Why didn't he play the Arcane Intellect first? Oh, he would have overdrawn, never mind.
Yeah, he had to at least coin out something. At the very least, coin. Ragnaros is going to come down, reducing the amount of targets it can hit. Very nice play here. In before Mirror Entity. You know what? This would be an excellent Mirror Entity play, but Savich is not going to play that in Freeze Mage. Alright, so now he's got two turns of Ice Blocking, so he's fairly okay with that.
But how do you
sort of.
You don't have the damage to win the game.
So what if you Emperor... No, you've already used a Frostbolt. I was going to say Emperor Coin Ice Block. Does that solve the problem? But not really. I think that's ultimately your only line of play, though. You have two Ice Block turns, which means...
And you know what's funny? You can't kill the bombs on your turn because you die.
Yeah, it's impossible. Which is the one of the plays that I feel is one of the most underrated ones by a lot of players, is letting the Mage deal with Dr. Boom because he really just can't handle it.
Yep. Agree.
Yeah, Firebat doesn't rate that play very highly as well. Or either, should I say. Ah! Punch the face, they said. It will be fun, they said.
But it's not.
Blizzard would be a nice top deck, though.
What? It doesn't achieve much. Look at that Deathlord.
Oh man, there's absolutely nothing that Savage can really do here, can he?
There's an Antonidas.
Oh man, so close. He's one mana away from Alexstrasza Ice Block.
What?
No. No. Okay, maybe he thought he was on 10 for a second there. Whoa, yeah, I almost had a heart attack here. I almost had a heart attack. Archmage Ice Block? No way. But that's kind of the only thing you can do. And now... Well, I think this is a lost game, quite frankly.
You can freeze the Ragnaros.
That's a great play. Maybe it won't fire if it's frozen.
That's the same with the Fire Elemental, right?
Yeah, it's the same problem. It's how do you freeze a Fire Lord? Wow, that's
How do you use freezing spells on Blackrock Mountain board? Doesn't make any sense. It has to be super hot there.
If you what?
If you play freeze spells on Blackrock Mountain board, you know.
Well, liquid nitrogen and fire, that's an interesting reaction. Alright, so...
To play Ice Block and Icelands?
Icelands, I think that's all you've got, but it's horrible.
You get only two fireballs, which is not enough.
Well...
The game, I think.
Yeah,
he didn't use the Icelands. What? Why?
He was hoping for Frostbolt top deck. Would that even be enough if he had it? I think he's just going through the motions here. Firebat got the win very convincingly. Look at the amount of aggression that Priest put up against Mage. I'm actually mind blown right now. Does Flamestrike achieve anything? Ever?
What's happening? I'm not actually following the game right now.
I don't think it matters that you Icelands anything, to be honest. Like, ultimately, it's all the same. Alright, he's just...
Oh, he's just BMing, okay.
BMing to the very end, although it's not a huge BM. Firebat gets the win 2-0 here against Savish. I think that Deathlord was... how much damage did it deal? Like, 10, 12?
From turn 4, right?
Yeah, about that. I think it dealt like 10 damage total.
5, 10, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 7 attacks, 14 damage.
Yeah, that's a crazy death lore. So 2-0 for Firebat right now in the series. Those were pretty quick games for what should have been control-heavy decks from my perspective. So Firebat's down to one last deck. He's got a mage left, and Savich might stick to his own mage depending on what that is. If it's Mech Mage, Freeze Mage tends to have a bit of an edge, to say the least.
I have no archetype like glued to the Firebat. Like,
for mages?
He can play both.
Yeah. The thing is, Savich has a Kazan Mystic, so that's an edge against Mech Mage.
And against Freeze Mage.
And against Freeze Mage as well. So
yep.
Maybe Savich was targeting Firebat's Mage by some weird, mysterious, mystical thinking. Maybe Savich was targeting the Mage and has a perfect lineup for it.
You think so?
We haven't seen anything else, right? What if his Warrior contains 2 Kazan Mystics and his Druid contains 2 Kazan Mystics?
That would be insane.
Yeah, what if? What if?
Interesting tactics are open for Conquest format, right?
Yeah.
It's so different than from the last Hero Standing.
Both are valid formats, but I feel like Conquest is, as far as planning your matchup, trying to target a specific deck from your opponent and building hardly around it, that's a much more viable approach in Conquest than it is in Last Hero Standing. Because you then have to tailor your matchups one-to-one, and if you lose a deck, unless you can bring it back to life, then it can be really problematic.
True.
Alright, so it's going to be Savich's Warrior versus Firebat's Mage. So apparently Savich is probably pinning Firebat on Freeze Mage, which means Warrior is going to be his go-to choice. If it is indeed Control Warrior, Firebat may just escape concede. I mean, he's done it.
If he did that last time, I would be not surprised by the same view right now.
Yeah. Well.
Well, what?
Let's see. I'm curious to see if Firebat is playing Mech or Freeze Mage. That's really what really
I think
is going to determine this, right?
I think the spectator bugged again on Firebat's perspective.
That's great. Thank you. Thank you, BaseBlizz. At least we have spectator mode now. It's funny because I realized about, 2 days ago, the speed at which we as players are requesting features is probably 10 times faster than the speed at which they can develop them. But they did fix the spectator bug, by the way, recently, or today even, where you can now have 2 players invite you to the game.
Oh, they did fix it.
They did fix that, yeah. So that's one less hassle that organizers will have to deal with. So that's already a really good thing. And that should simplify the organizers' jobs in the future.
Knife juggler.
All right, wow. So maybe this is the, not even a mech. Could not even be mech. Clockwork doesn't even say anything about that. It's seen everywhere. It's seen in... This is obviously aggressive because of juggler, right?
Yep.
Mirror image, Sorcerer's Apprentice... Yeah. Oh, never mind. It's mech. it just happens to contain a knife juggler.
Because it's great with the mech warper synergy, and it's great against Face Hunter, I would assume.
Yeah, and Firebat is going to go for the lockdown play on Savich, who hasn't found an axe to handle this guy. So he's going to be desperate to remove the snow chugger as soon as possible, but he's in for a surprise with that follow-up from Firebat. Oh, man. I wouldn't feel too good here if in Savich's position.
I wouldn't too.
I mean, how do you handle all of this at once?
And you can't use your weapon.
I guess Armor Up Shield Slam trade is going to be a way to deny the future's value from the Snow Chugger, but you know what? That is a great card.
It's still far away.
It feels far away, but it's really good that he found it. This card might be what makes him take this game, possibly, because he can kill 2 minions, or at least 1 with that Armorsmith, if he trades it away with Cruel Task, if he decides not to kill the... How do you feel about Whirlwind Cruel Task and trade into Mech Warper?
Why not just Cruel Task into... Armorsmith trading for MechWarper and ending the turn.
So you don't whirlwind the 2-1? Yeah, I mean, if he wants to ping, he'll do that anyway.
Yeah, and otherwise he will lose the creature anyway.
Yeah.
And then you have a 2-1 Chugger on board, which can be dealt with the whirlwind next turn. I'm not sure. Everything seems okay here, I would say.
I mean, when you've got a brawl, that whirlwind feels much less valuable.
Yeah,
because
exactly.
You can actually throw it away much more readily. So... Alright. MechWarper is gone.
Yeah, so he goes for that.
Alright.
Firebat is overextending really heavily.
Yeah. He's going to get punished. If anything. So trade and Mana Worm.
Coolant seems okay.
Usually you want to keep it for Archmage, but in this position it's perfectly fine because you're at risk of losing your minions by doing so.
Oh wow.
What a great top deck here for Savage. Gonna be able to clear this board up with double shield slam, and Brawl is still there on the back end. You know what? He might have been frustrated by that turn one Snowchugger, but he seems to be doing pretty well so far. And that Brawl is kind of an insurance against Mechmage.
Insurance, but now with when Firebat won't be like overextending the board, it does a lot. It has a lot of less sense than before, I think.
Yeah, of course, it's a lot less powerful. But unless Firebat finds his biggest threats, you should be able to handle this mid game pretty well. I don't think Savich is overly worried. Oh wow, and he finds the Emperor. I think you just drop it.
Yeah,
like
you drop
a bomb.
It.
Drop it like Dr. Boom.
You got Whirlwind for zero mana. That's insane.
Yeah, that's going to allow you to be a little more flexible with the way you play for the Executes and the Acolytes of Pain. This guy's deck is crazy! Look at that Brawl.
Yeah,
four mana Brawl into Acolyte of Pain. That seems pretty legit.
Bro or bust.
Yep, no thoughts given, just drop that Brawl. And what stays? It's the biggest minion.
The biggest minion, and Savage is super salty.
So you just go for Whirlwind, top deck, execute, and be done with it, right? Never mind, he doesn't bother. Oh, wow. That's definitely the worst possible outcome. And look at that, Firebat top deck's a good curve nonetheless, with a freezing effect. Dr. Balance comes out. Oh wow, the doctor. Okay, let's go for RNG boss.
Phew, I didn't suspect that, to be honest.
Me neither, that was a snap play.
Oh, Savage will be like mind blown by that.
The mine of NACL that is currently cropping up is unbelievably big. Now, what he has to do is probably trade away.
That sucked so much.
I mean, I don't even know. I feel like that might have been a bit too fast for Savage, because if you just drop Dr. Boom, the opponent still has to answer it, and unless he top decks Fireball, the second one even, because he's used the first one on Emperor, then you should be okay.
I just don't get it, why would you sacrifice the bombs?
Yeah, if they're just gonna get traded away, right?
Well, it maybe will save you like 4 points of damage, but it guarantees you so much more when you can dictate the trades. Like when he plays...
Exactly.
He has to go with minions, with more minions on board after you play the Dr. Boom, because there was no brawl, there was a brawl already. And then you have more chances to actually hit an effective boom bot, right?
Yeah. It's more likely you will hit a boom bot by doing so. Well, he does find a Belcher, so his worries may be, you know, slightly mitigated in this position. I'll have to see what he finds of the Shredder if he does play it. Oh, he finds an Archmage. That's not a bad draw. Not but super. Actually, it is pretty useful here. You trade your everything, then you trade away your Pallid Shredder into Dr. Boom, and you drop Archmage. See what Savitas does. Do you do that ever? Because, like, you've pretty much got, like, he can play everything he wants here.
Well, he didn't execute yet, so this might be a problem.
But there's no charge been taken off. Alright, he's not gonna opt for that line of play.
Yeah, I think this is better, because now if he dubtecks anything, like a spell, he kills the warrior. And without the Blast Mage, you wouldn't be able to do that, right?
So you have to attack Blast Mage, and then you Alexstrasza yourself and hope for the best.
And one spell guarantees lethal.
Frostbolt, Fireball, yeah, any of those will win the game. Nope. Lotheb is not that, but it allows a good ping. So, still quite a bit of damage coming Savitch's way.
It's funny that Clockwork Gnome would be one of the greatest draws here. Unless, of course, Frostbolt.
Yeah, Frostbolt would probably be the best, but he finds an execute for 6.
Wait, is he still dead?
No, you attack then you execute Lotheb.
Yes, you're right.
You can even play Acolyte, but then you're dead to Fireball if you do that, right? Actually, you're still dead to it no matter what, because the 3-2 would kill you with it.
Yes, sir.
Well, the armor of time has come, and Firebat is going to need to top deck something fierce. There's one Fireball only left in this deck, and Archmage is out of the way. Dr. Boom would be a great draw, but maybe not even enough.
Frostbolt, one turn.
Whoa, so close, yet so far away. I think you have to keep it, right?
I would say the same, but he goes to kill the Alexstrasza.
So he's relying on the top deck Fireball. That's his one draw. It would kill.
It's only for one turn.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
That's it. He's got one turn to top deck it. One draw to rule them all. That's not it.
I kind of didn't get the...
You know what, Savitch plays Ysera, so he gave his opponent another turn to actually find the Fireball.
Oh yeah, right.
And I have to say, I'm not too sure about that. Maybe playing Acolyte would have been slightly better.
I was thinking, in this position, you have to armor up every single turn.
Yeah, but he did not.
I would definitely do that. And now Firebat has one more chance.
Yeah, and actually he's got two chances, in fact. This is one of them, but he could get it again next turn if he pings face. That's another win condition. Savitch gave his opponent two more turns to find the Fireball. I am not sure. Oh, well, that Lotheb. Actually, no, yes, it does. It does,
yeah,
seal the game.
It does seal the deal, yeah.
All right.
But that was nine really mana. Risky. I think Savitch didn't think that through.
I don't know, but it wasn't a big deal in this specific case, but it could have been. Because I think we only saw one Fireball on Emperor Thorsten, and that was it. Oh, that was close. So I guess Savitch could still disconnect.
Don't say that, man.
Why? Do you not believe in the power of disconnects?
I do believe. Charge. Well, that's enough, right?
Yeah, with these are awakens, yeah, it's more than enough.
It's like 800 damage.
Yeah. Well, Easter Awakens is gonna seal the deal here. Imagine if that had been a Leper Gnome.
And first execute is being drawn here.
Second one. He's played the first one.
Oh yeah, right.
Very earlier minion. So that's gonna be one game first of each. He's gonna be able to take it with his warrior against Firebat's mage. Now he knows it's Mech Mage, and Savitch has two more decks on the back end. Since he couldn't win with either of them, he's got his Freeze Mage, I think, still that he hasn't won with to this point, and he's also got a Druid deck, which has a pretty tough time versus Mech Mage in general.
It should be a really tough matchup. But we'll see now a Mage versus Mage.
Yeah, Mech Mage versus Freeze Mage is typically good for the Freeze Mage, but there's always a chance that the Mech Mage gets a really, really solid Lotheb turn, and that turns everything around.
Yep.
I think Lotheb is probably one of the biggest cards, or at least from what I've seen.
You remember what were people saying when Lotheb was previewed on the site? Everyone went crazy with Lotheb. It's like, what? Best card in the game. Well, yeah. I said that too. I still think that.
Well, I think it's one of the best cards in the game for sure. It's one of those cards that if somebody asks you, what should I get when I start a collection? You're like, well, get Nax for Sludge Belcher and Lothab and Zombie Chow and Mad Scientist if you have specific decks in mind. So there are a lot of good cards that came out in that first win.
And Shadow of Naxxramas.
Yeah, lots of cards are just amazing. Actually,
when you think about it, Nax has so much value, it's insane.
Compared to BRM, it feels that way, but we haven't seen the whole BRM picture painted, I guess, at this point. So we still have to wait, but from predictions, I guess people were a lot more hopeful about the power level of Naxxramas than they were about that of BRM.
Well, it's a good sign that the BRM is not like heightening the power creep at all.
Yeah, that's great.
In my opinion. So it's really cool to see solid cards that can change the decks to new archetypes. I mean, spawn new archetypes, but are not like super overpowered.
Yeah, Undertaker, right? I don't want to see that again.
Like, oh, yeah.
We don't want to see power creep of that level ever again. So we're going to be going through Mage versus Mage here, Freeze Mage versus Mech Mage. I want to see what happens with the starting hand for Savage, because that is going to be a huge factor. All right. Well, I saw Clockwork Gnome. And a Mech Warper. And a Doomsayer. That's good for Savage.
It's really good. That's true.
Yeah, saying it's good doesn't make it justice. The Frostbolt and the Doomsayer together can handle so much of what the Mech Mage will do.
You dropped the spider tank, right? Yeah.
I think it's much better than the Mana Worm in Onoichon, yeah.
And you dropped the Blast Mage next turn.
On curve, you force the opponent to play removal or find a freeze right away.
Oh, he has the Frost Nova Doomsayer. So now I'm not sure about the Doomsayer anymore. I mean, about the Blast Mage anymore. But
yeah, but you have to try
it. It's still too great on paper, so you have to go for it.
And I mean, he has taken 13 damage so far, so that is still not too bad. Now, I'm curious to see if Firebat finds Tinkertown at all and find Reversing Switch to kill a Doomsayer, because that would be crazy. Reversing Switch is also an unspoken MVP. You know what? I think I would ping my Clockwork here and try to find the Reversing Switch.
Yeah, I would do that.
Oh my god, I can't believe I never thought of that play in my life. That's the first time I actually think about that.
Really?
Yeah, I've never even thought of pinging my own Clockwork to kill a Doomsayer in this position. Never. I don't know why.
Okay.
Yeah, I have never really considered it as a line of play, and I play Freeze Mage. And I've never run into it, so... Interesting, because I know the Reversing Switch is the best for Doomsayer. It's just that getting it in a position like this would have been so good for him.
Agree. Well, now he has to sacrifice the Loot Hoarder first just to see the options. He will most likely play the Frostbolt on the Navjager anyway.
Yeah, the only time where it's not really relevant is when you're afraid of a second Mech Mage, Blast Mage, but then you kill that with Flamestrike, so that's usually fine. Dr. Balanced!
It's turn 7 and it's glowing green. What do you do? You play it.
Yeah, and you know what's funny is that Savage has a Flamestrike, but he can't quite kill Dr. Boom, even with sacrificing the Archmage.
Yeah, it's 6 points of damage. I mean, 5.
So does he just fireball it? Yes, he does.
And you kill both bombs right now. You
I'd venture to
bombs.
Say so, yeah. Hey, Blizzard. I mean, you can kill them next turn as well, since you're not even playing... What's her name? Alexstrasza?
Mm-hmm. Oh.
So it's probably fine to wait. Alright, so Firebat is just vomiting his head on the board and hoping there's no more AoE from Savage, but he's gonna be disappointed.
Flamestrike
is waiting.
You think that's a right call to drop everything on the board?
It's not like you really have a choice, to be frank.
Yeah.
I mean, you have to push for damage and hope for the best, but...
So, well, that's a good card, but I don't think you can win this game anymore.
It's like one turn too late, isn't it?
Yeah.
last turn, instead of the plays that he had,
that would
he
be
could
insane.
Have sealed a Lotheb and taken this. So what is Firebat looking for here?
I would say this.
This is probably at the top of his list.
And you can deal with the Antonidas of your opponent. Seems to be nice.
Holy cow. Talk about a top deck. That is crazy. So he just shaking his head in disbelief.
Again.
Like, oh, really?
Levernaki.
Oh, wow. Well, he got one fireball, so... Savich is still not dead. He's got a nice barrier.
But he has no way of dealing with the Antonidas, man. Wait, there. He hasn't.
Yeah, he does with Blizzard Icelands, but it's just like a huge overinvestment to get it done.
You have to do it.
Yeah. And as soon as your ice block gets popped, you just Alex Russell yourself and you should be safe. I think you have to do this. There's no way you don't. The only card left in your opponent's hand is a fireball. And Ice Bearer does nothing for that. And if you don't kill it now... Oh, is he perhaps considering Alex Straza, like, the face of the opponent and then trying to go for lethal soon?
How do you go for lethal then?
Oh, soon. Like, because he forces a trade with the Archmage, right? He would force the Archmage to do something. It's going to be a double fireball, and then the Archmage...
Well, he has the Chasm Mystic. Following
turn.
So cute.
Never mind. The straightforward play that we saw initially is the one he took. I think it makes too much sense not to make. For the face!
Emperor doesn't do much.
Explosive sheep. Hello. Wow.
Nice.
I've seen you in a bit. The light doesn't discriminate, except against Mechmages. Then I guess it does discriminate. So Firebat will not pop the ice barrier if he can afford it.
And
right?
There's
like
no
there's
way.
No
he can
way.
Win the game.
Yeah.
Even if he doesn't pop it, then you would have to draw the second fireball, and it doesn't change much because your opponent will be still at like 4 HP. Right?
Does he play Rag? Sense.
Well, Rag can change a bit, but it's too late for the Rag anyway.
He can pop the block, but he's not going to win on the following turn, sadly. He just found the lethal, well, the ice block pop, rather, if he could actually go through the ice barrier, but he can't, so this is pretty much... gonna be game. Although he could hope to top deck minions and Savich has a, you know, blank hand. Just doesn't seem very likely.
Well, this suck. This certainly suck.
So they're both gonna ping each other to death like a Hunter Mirror match? What is this I'm looking at? Yeah, it looks like it. Alright, well, Firebat wants to top deck another fireball to kill the Emperor. And then he pings face. And then Savich pings face. And then the other player pings face.
Yep. Well, this is a game.
Yep. Alright, so Firebat is going to lose another game to Savich.
Freeze Mage.
It's going to be equalizing the entire lineup. So Savich is down to one last deck, his Druid. Now, we mentioned that Mech Mage tends to have a pretty favorable matchup against Druid, but
maybe,
depending on how Savich built it...
Yeah, exactly. Maybe he has like double Kazan's Mystics, and that's it. That would be enough, most of the time.
If he targeted that specific deck from Firebat... Because, I mean, I didn't see Mirror Entity, nor like Mad Scientist in Firebat's deck.
And he plays Knife Juggler. Maybe that replaces the Mad Scientist.
That is what I think. So I suspect maybe that's what Firebat's running. And as a result, some of the staple cards are not there. So it's going to be Druid versus Mage. And Kazan Mystic becomes a dead card because there are no secrets. And maybe that's a response to the fact that Kazan Mystic was on the rise, that Firebat took those secrets out of his deck.
That might be right, but we still didn't see like the whole deck from Firebat. So we just can't be sure of that.
Yeah, we haven't seen everything, but the two knife jugglers require a cut. We also saw a Harvest Golem, which I'm not sure what it's replacing. Perhaps one of the two possible spider tanks, but I've seen two spider tanks, I'm fairly sure, in one of the games. So I'm really not sure what Firebat cut for those. Two mirror entities would allow for Harvest Golems and two knife jugglers for the Mad Scientist.
Probably.
That would be about it. All right.
So what's the next matchup? Druid versus Mage, as we said. Yep. So
that's it. That's going to be the last match. They're 2-2 right now, so that's going to be the last game that determines who takes the match. It's going to be match point either way. Whichever of these players gets the win.
And we'll be jumping into the game. And okay. Well, this seems nice for Savish with the Wild Growth.
See me ramping.
But Firebat's hand is not bad either.
I'd say both hands are actually really solid. Yeah, both hands are really good, and they just improved slightly. The Innervate, however, that Innervate.
And he has the Kaizen Mystic, as we said, but still no secrets in sight from Firebat. This is,
you know, hilarious. What? Did Firebat actually boil it down to the point where he thought he'd run into Kazan Mystics? And Savich, now that he's seen Knife Jugglers, knows that there's none.
Yeah.
Oh my god, that is exactly it. That's some meta thinking right there.
But the Goblin Blast Mage strikes again. Oh wow. The assault is real. But Savish didn't even react this time.
Yeah, it's the first time I don't see him react to something like this. He's a very emotional player usually. But not in this case.
He doesn't care anymore.
We can make a new guild in World of Warcraft called Saltier Than Salt, if you will. You can play that. You want?
No, thank you.
Jump into it today. You sure about that? Come on.
Yeah, I'm not the WoW player. You think I am?
I'll invite Forsen then. We can roleplay together. Oh, two Ancients of Lore here. That's not too bad.
Well, the Force of Nature is not bad either.
Actually, wait. Is it good game? Oh my god. Fireball phase? And then Fireball phase. Is that it?
Wait. Here we go.
6, 5, 10, 12. Yes, that would be it. Unless the armor up from Savich or Curse or Ancient of Lore is played. So Firebat, to make sure that he finds a bit more damage and safety, is going to go for the Lothab play. But this is pretty much lethal in hand as far as he's concerned.
Well, Savich will use both Ancient of Lore for heals.
There's no question about that, yes.
And he will use the creatures to trade, but still leave one creature on board, which can then trade with Lothab next turn. So most likely that will be the Shade. Nope.
Yeah, you have to ensure lore yourself here not to die, but you're still very scared in Savich's position. And that mage start was crazy. And fireball ping face, I guess. Or you could ping the Drake, I guess, if you're afraid of another ancient. That probably makes more sense for consistency's sake.
You have to fireball this turn, right? You have to win next turn.
You know, I'm surprised Savich actually decided to freeze the Shade and not the Drake.
But the Shade would die.
Would have died anyway, yeah. It wouldn't have mattered in this case. Never mind.
So
Fail Fish. Alright, so
this tells Savish that, okay, I have two fireballs in my hand.
Yeah, pretty much. He's got to go all in on it, but Savish is going to be able to counter it. This is like a really clutch second ancient.
Yeah, this is like so
Firebat doesn't
so
want to see this. Oh no, he's regretting the move.
Oh
no,
Lebernaki. Again.
The last thing Firebat wanted to see just came up. Now he has to use a fireball and a minion.
This is awful. And Shade can trade for the Worm, but that doesn't really matter because there's two reps.
Yep. Oh man, that game might have just flipped. That's an incredible double ancient for Savish. Anything else would have been lethal, effectively. Like, he would have died.
Yeah, that's true.
I guess the Lothar would have stopped it, but not by much.
Mm-hmm. Druid the Claw, great draw. So you can ignore the Verm. You can just ping it for one and play Druid Taunt mode.
So plot twist.
What, he goes
Firebat for plays Pyroblast. No, he's still dead to Force Nature anyway.
Pyroblast will be playable in two turns. That's
yeah,
not
he's dead. Long dead.
Wow!
Firebat gets reverse sweeped by Savich, went 0-2 and then 3-2 in this series, and that is going to be match point for Savich. He's got to feel pretty good about that one, because that was a sick series of matches.
There was some salty reactions from both players.
I mean, Savich got a really few unlucky positions where he just couldn't believe his bad luck, but he's going to take the first game against Firebat. The first match. Now, Firebat's going to be playing right up again against Trifecrow, who's currently, you know, 4-1 in the lead and in the league. Firebat is now 3-3, I think. So Savich goes up to 4-3. Firebat is 3-3. Firebat has the chance to go up 4-3 as well and equalize with Savich if he beats Strifecrow. But if he doesn't, he's going to fall behind a little bit. And that's going to feel a little awful after this reverse sweep.
True. Well, Saldvich won the game and the press bet will be going.
Saldvich?
Yeah, Saldvich.
Saldvich! All right, so we'll be right back after the break, guys. It's going to be Strifecrow versus Firebat for the last match of the day. King Gwyn Pro League will keep going. Do not go.